What's up, guys, and welcome back to Game of Thrones, the game. Last episode, we finally met our second half of the dynamic duo to go with Moore's Cardboard Westford. Alistair looks a lot more eccentric and less brutish, and his classes seem to reflect that. So now comes another huge game-changing decision. What class do we play for the next 20-plus hours? So I saved you guys a lot of the BS of me trying to decide who I was going to play, and I decided I was going to try the Water Dancer. Mostly because, actually, in the actual HBO series, the only Water Dancer character is actually one of my favorite. Not only that, he was a complete badass, so that lends to tell me that I should probably stick with someone like this. I think because he gets so much from agility, it's probably best to buff his agility, his luck, and his intelligence. Because Water Dancers use brains above brawn, speed, and technique. I didn't even look at his skills before, so what does this do? Mobilize your opponent by striking him in the legs. Vicious circle. Chance of critical hit plus 2% with each critical performed. So does that stay on forever, or does it have a duration? Interesting. Quick as a snake. Strike all enemies surrounding you within range of 3 meters. This ability is executed from your current position. So basically, you could deal damage in an area. Effortlessly find a flaw in your opponent's defense and knock him down. Opportunist, you know how to take advantage of beneficial situations when they arise. If your opponent is knocked down, you get a guaranteed crit. Nice. Sting of the Manticore, strike a death blow to an opponent who has been knocked down. So is that an instant kill? That's pretty amazing. I think I'm happy about this. Your defensive position is strike back. Counterattack, strong as a bear. Stun your opponent by striking them in the face. Bully, taunt your enemies. So he's kind of like part tank, part damage dealer. So kind of like the sword and shield dude. Maybe I should play the assassin type guy, because we already have a sword user that's pretty heavy on the sword. Maybe I should play the cell sword. Nah, this is gonna go with the water dancer. I don't trust my teammates, my bad. I really don't. Alright, let's go the damage path for now. We'll go one in light as a feather, and we'll do this vicious circle. Every time I deal damage, plus 5% after each dodge. Nice. So yeah. Obviously we use swords. I'll put 5 there. Get 5 in our armor. There's really nothing for, like, just a single blade using guy, except for when you play as an assassin, I guess, so. What I was thinking was, why don't we go more roleplay-ish and just do something like, he's an intelligent guy, so we'll get him 2 extra skill points. And because of that, what can we take to cover that? No. We can make him an asthmatic. I mean, plus 8% isn't that big a deal. It's like 3 energy. if something costs 40 energy, it's like 3 energy more. Or 4 energy more, which isn't really a big deal. That's like a tenth of a second.
But we're starving, we are!
Then get some food! I'm out of ham sandwiches. You gotta talk to Moore's, bro.
Ships. It isn't. With things as they are, what choice do we have?
If things are so bad, what do you propose to do?
It's been too hard for too long. It's time to revolt. We must take matters into our own hands. We'll take up arms.
If you follow that path, the army will have no choice but to fight against you. Do you want this to end in blood and tears?
You don't know what you're talking about, stranger. The house is dying. The army of River Spring is but a shadow of what it was. You obviously know nothing of the misery we suffer here.
That may be, but I do know that violence is answered with more violence. This path never ends well.
We're already suffering. What is it to us if we die of hunger or by a sword?
What has happened here? These lands were once thriving.
It's the lords. It's been too long since they cared about what happens in their own lands. Neighboring lords have taken the chance to grab some of our land, and nothing is done to stop it. And now that Lord Sarwick is dead, it will only get worse. We must do something.
But there are still Sarwicks in Riverspring.
Don't make me laugh. The eldest fled years ago. As for the others, they're no better than he. Anyway, this concerns only the people of Riverspring, stranger.
So be it. I pray that your choices will not lead you to reckless acts. May R'hllor light your path through the shadows.
Get that shit, let's get some TV!
I've heard enough already.
This guy runs like such a goofball. Okay, so I figured out I'm a priest. I don't know what priest carries a sword, but... apparently I'm a priest that takes no shit.
When it rains now, we have to burn it. To stay warm.
Sad story.
I think that's everything in this area.
Forgive my boldness, noble stranger, but I cannot let you walk into certain death like that.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm not sure of the customs in the free cities nowadays, but I wouldn't dream of entering Westeros' arm like that. And yet, as the smith labors day and night for us, it so happens that I sell the finest weapons. Blunt, cutting, perforating. You know what they say, my lord. Don't buy your blade until you know what you plan to stick it into.
Tell me more about blunt weapons.
Ah, the pure power of a mace. Our good king would certainly approve. Blunt weapons are especially designed to fight against heavy armor such as plate. They crush it. Can you see? Bam! Do you need more information?
No, I know what everything does already.
I have things to do.
Don't hesitate to come back and see me in the Merchant Square. I weep to see you so ill-equipped in this town. And don't forget, you'll be wanting armor. After all, no matter the weapon you face, simple clothes will not protect you.
Effectiveness of weapons. All weapons destroy clothing, obviously. Cutting weapons are good against light armor. Perforating weapons are good against medium armor. And blunt weapons are good against heavy armor. Okay. So you get a 15% damage boost. So it's probably smart to go with like one item that does light damage and one that breaks through medium. That'd be good. Because I don't think Alistair can use maces.
That won't help matters.
Not very talkative, Mr. Blacksmith.
Because I'm a blacksmith. I don't want to talk to you.
How much money do I have? What does it say? Seriously. Oh, I have 20 silver? I can't buy anything! Why am I here? He's like, I hate to see you so ill-equipped, but then you can't sell me anything? Let me get out of here. You're a punk ass. What about you? Can you sell me a dagger or something? Oh, I have a dagger. Well, I need a sword. How much for a sword? 24? I still can't afford a sword. I can't afford anything, and one arrow is 20 silver. Like, really? 20 silver for an arrow? I'm glad I didn't pick Archer. What are you selling? Potions. Alright, so they send me in town with enough money not to buy a damn thing. I don't see the point. Is this game is literally trolling me right now.
You got trolled, bro.
How you feel?
It's as sick as a rabid hellhound. It's been coming out of both ends for 2 days now.
Can't you see I'm busy looking for barrels I can loot? I don't know why this game has frame rate issues, dude. The graphics are not good. They're just not good. I don't understand. This is Unreal Engine 3. It's... They should just rename it to the Unreally Fucking Old Engine 3 because it's so old. Ha! Now maybe I could buy something. Oh, I see a barrel. This barrel's gotta have something. It's at the end of a walkway. Or not. Alright, this shit's getting old. Let's move on.
Halt, priest. This town is in mourning. Access to the castle is closed during the ceremony.
I'm actually here to attend Lord Sarwick's burial.
I'm afraid that's not possible. I'm under strict orders to only allow entry to close kin. With the villagers' current grumblings, we don't want to risk problems.
Please call Maester Harwin.
The ceremony is about to begin. I doubt he'll come for a priest of R'hllor. John, go inform Maester Harwin and bring back Captain Ryman.
Good old Ryman, Captain of the Guard. Things certainly have changed in my absence.
What is going on here? Why has John gone for the Maester?
Ryman, it's me, Alistair.
Several hells! Alistair? Graydon, I told you only family. That excludes peasants, dogs, and cravens who abandon their families.
You blame me for leaving, but this is not the time for anger. I've come to bury my father, Ryman, not to fight with you. In honor of the past, allow me to go and pay him my respects.
Very well. You may go. Out of respect for your father.
Alistair, I knew you would come.
Maester Harwin, it's a pleasure to see you again.
The pleasure is shared. Seven gods, you have changed so much. 50 years. I had help from my contacts in Braavos to inform you of your father's death. The funeral will be in the Godswood. The ceremony has already begun.
Why is it not held at the Sept?
It would be if it were not in ruins. Riverspring is suffering on all fronts, I fear. Let us go now. Come with me, Alistair. Let us speak as we walk.
What happened here, Maester? How could my father allow things to get to this point?
You know, after you left, Lord Reynold changed. He began to live more and more in the past, and stopped taking care of his duty.
Oh my god, he's the devil! Kill him! Or we could keep walking.
Your sister quickly found herself managing more than she should have.
Eliana helped my father govern.
Well...
These last few months, she's practically run the house herself.
You talk slow. You talk funny, bro. Oh, I think I broke it.
In spite of her efforts, she was unable to slow the inevitable ruin of her lands without a lord. But all is not so dark. Many of your father's vassals remain faithful to their oath. They have all come to the burial in order to honor his memory. We will speak of all this again after the ceremony. Let us make haste, I beg of you.
We're here.
Hello, Red Priest. I am Lady Eliana Sarwick, daughter of the late Lord Sarwick. You are just in time for the ceremony. Were you close to my father?
You have changed much in 15 years, little sister.
Alistair, Why have you returned? We don't need you here.
Harwin told me of father's death. It was my duty to come.
15 years without any news. And he had to die for us to see you again. You would have done better to stay where you were.
I do not doubt that my departure was difficult for you.
Difficult? To say the least, your disappearance was our father's ruin. Do you know how long I cried after you left? And how long I hoped for news of you?
I am sorry. I left Westeros without once turning back, it's true. I understand your reaction. It must have been unbearable for you. But I had to leave. Know that I never forgot you.
That's easy for you to say. And you should know that we here learn to live very well without you.
I understand your reaction, Elias.
It shows!
Does it. Go pay your last respects to father. We will speak later.
This place is a freaking slum.
The stranger.
We're living fine without you. In poverty, plague, and filled with STDs.
And may he judge you fairly and deliver you from the torments of the seven hells. Your qualities.
Who is that man? I believe that is the Elder Sawick, the one who disappeared. He has certainly changed, but I recognize him.
Ew. That was so hot. Apparently nobody likes that Alistair just made out with his dad.
I will summon a beard apocalypse on
you! How could we desecrate our father's body
that way? Flaming beards will fall from the heavens and destroy you all!
I performed the final kiss, the tribute that priests of R'hllor pay to the dead.
You may be a red priest, but you should respect the beliefs of Riverspring.
I guess corpses are better than little boys. Damn, my bad!
Do not think that it is easy for me to speak with you after all this time.
I understand.
Please, Elyana, listen. I left Westeros without a goodbye, and you have every reason to be angry with me. 15 years ago, the war that King Robert Baratheon fought to claim the throne forced me to commit deeds which haunt me still. The very idea of returning to you was too painful. I did the only thing left for me to do. I left and began a new life elsewhere. Not long ago, I received a letter from Maester Harwin telling of father's death. I could no longer hide myself. It was time to confront my past. What I regret the most, Elyana, is that by fleeing to the other side of the waters, it is you whom I wounded.
All these years, I have thrown a veil over your memory. And you return at the moment when everything is in turmoil. I must be alone for the moment. I will see you later.
Wasn't it just fine 35 seconds ago?
Take your time, sister. I understand.
Make up your mind,
Alistair?
Crazy woman.
Maester Arwen would like to speak with you. He awaits you in the castle courtyard. And if I may add, you should be ashamed of that kiss during the ceremony.
My thanks, Ravella. I shall go and see him.
You know, when two bros love each other so much, you just gotta let the natural course of things happen. Okay, lady? I don't think she's for gay marriage.
I am not sure there is more to discuss between us, Alistair. I am sincerely sorry for your loss. You know how much your father meant to me.
I am sincerely sorry for your ugly.
Unless you are ready to listen to me, it would be best that you leave.
I knew you to be less ardent, Ravella.
And I knew you to be more respectful. This ceremony was held under the watch of the Seven, and your shameful act did nothing but needlessly shock and disgust decent people.
I am sorry, Scepter. From now on, the rights of the Seven no longer concern me. I have chosen another path. Can you not see that you and all the lost souls of Westeros worship different rays of the same light? Your entire pantheon, your seven gods, do you not feel that they are just pieces of one whole, of something much bigger?
If you would listen to my lessons, you would know that for the sages, the seven are but one. But in order to understand that, one must understand the full scope of their teachings. Perhaps it would be better to worship a simple wood fire like other red priests do. It's always easier to worship that which burns brightly.
The flame brings light and warmth. It is the source of life.
No doubt other creatures share your beliefs. Like those whores, for example. I've seen one of your kind in action. Thoris of Myr was his name. A fornicator and a drunk.
Where does he hang out?
To err is to be human. Our order does not encourage lust, Revella. But the pleasures of the flesh are not altogether forbidden, if they are carried out in an act of love. And I myself have seen fat septons give themselves over to drink. However, I don't judge all septons based on these rare cases.
I've heard it all. A heretic daring to judge a true believer.
I will not allow you to speak to me in this manner, Revella. I respect your beliefs, and you will respect mine.
Forgive me, my lord. I forgot my place.
Your fervor does you credit, Revella. You raised me, as you raised my brother and sister. But I cannot allow one of my subjects to show me disrespect. Do you understand?
Of course. I shall be careful in the future.
Better be Amazon.
I don't doubt it.
I'ma shank you,